Hello everybody, welcome to our new episode. As you can see, I just wanted to greet you with a nice landing video, and we are on board of an airplane which is headed to our international airport. So after our landing completes, we will start our tour. See you in a moment. Welcome back again everybody. Now we start our tour with our international airport. We are just seeing our airport in a nice top-down view. Let's start with our runways. As you already know that this is the default international airport which comes with the game, especially after that After Dark expansion, not a vanilla game. So those some assets you see are customized, downloaded from Steam Workshop, like that PAPI lightning and runway lightning, etc. Blast pad, etc. So I just gave numbers to my runways, and I already explained this how to give number thing in another video. If you check my channel or if you already downloaded those assets, I already shared them in Steam Workshop. You probably saw that video. I prepared for you to show you how to give numbers to those runways. So according to our my sun position and coordinates of my city, latitude and longitude, I gave numbers, and this one is 24, 33, etc. So those numbers are customized, created by a user in Steam Workshop, and I also edited them a bit and uploaded them to Steam Workshop, so you can find it if you search. So let me show you the start of other runway. This is the runway 15. Okie dokie. Now let's see our approach lights. Those are the approach lights. You can remember them from the real life airports, and it's nice asset in my opinion. Adds a realism to your airport construction with all of other those assets. So from a different view, especially at night, they really be an eye candy addition to your game, to your cities. I will also show the night view of the airport in a later moment, so no need to worry on that. So we already showed the runways, numbers and approach lights. Now next we have precision approach indicators. Those are the precision approach indicators. Those are the lights you, if you know already, I don't know, but according to your angle you are descending to the runway, those lights appear as white or red. If too white, like that you can see now, and too red is you see while you are descending, you are on the correct course and no need to worry. So just an addition, of course they are not working in the game, just an eye candy addition, eye candy asset to your airport construction. So there is nothing special about this terminal, default terminal which came with the After Dark expansion. I only added some lights on, as you can see now, on the default apron lighting. I just placed another light. I also downloaded them from the Steam Workshop and added them to my liking. They appear a bit bright, but maybe, I don't know, I did not like the default lighting of the airport. It was not too bright. I just added them. You will decide when you see at the night view of the airport, so you can adjust them according to your liking. So what you're seeing is now the main cargo operation of my international airport. As you can see, I just gave DHL and KLM operation of main cargo transportation by plane. Of course, imaginary transportation, since there are no cargo airplane operation supplied for the default game. They are just only eye candy additions. Unlike ships and trains, you cannot transport cargo with the plane. So just cosmetic things, decoration things. You can see we have customized aprons here. Some planes from different companies like American Airlines, Air Canada, KLM. What we have here, an airplane, FedEx, two cargo planes belongs to DHL, a British Airways A380, and three planes which belongs to Aeroflot and Turkish Airlines, just sitting in front of the fueling depot for refueling. And we have our backside entrance to our airport, which is near the recycle station, main garbage collection plant around this district, for this district especially. So you already saw the fuel depot, and our job done is this side of the airport. Let's see the other side, move there and see what we have there. So in the centralized location of our airport, we have some multi-story car parks and normal car parks for just eye candy operations. All those cars, car parks are working, by the way. Those are not props, just used by the citizens, sims of the city. Those multi-story car parks also working, as you can see now. People tend to park their cars in those multi-story parking locations and get bus to travel wherever they want. So I already show this bus terminal in the previous episode, so I don't want to explain it again and waste your precious time. We have two stations which you can grab some fuel for your car. We have some customized air control tower here. Those are already downloaded from Steam Workshop. I am not sure about those buildings. You can place them by using Rico add-on. I am just using Rico add-on, by the way. So this is another Department of Transportation road maintenance depot here. We have taxi, bus terminals, and another three great Rico buildings. One is Toyota car dealership. Nice creation, by the way. Thanks to the user who created this asset. Nice work, honestly. Next of Toyota service, we have Ford service, a car dealer. So you can come here. I just imagine that people just land to my city, to my international airport, and come here and rent cars, or if they just newly resident of the city, they come here and buy their new car. Currently we have only three dealership. I am not planning to add more, since I am done with the city, but on my next day I will probably add more. And as the last one, we have some nice Audi car dealership, Audi Skylines here, so you can buy again nice Audis from this building. A nice view of the around here. So the next neighborhood you see now is port. We will travel to there in a few minutes or seconds. All right, now we see our airport district on a top-down general view. So what we have here in this district, we have only commercial and office zones. Office zones, as you can imagine, it's kind of like since we have some cargo buildings here, they just cargo companies in which those office buildings and workers in those office buildings deal with import and export things, just an imaginary building style, so nothing special, nothing specific. Those long buildings, skyscrapers, are just tourist locations, hotels in what it seems, and people, especially tourists, can land the airport, come and just take the bus or tram or whatever. They just come here and stay their hotel, so they can move anywhere in the city, anywhere they want around the city. I just wanted to place them for again testing how those trams which came with the snowfall expansion acts or affects the population or transportation habits. So this zone is mainly a testing zone, especially the backsides of this zone, which includes a lot of tall buildings. By the way, you can see though there are no tall buildings here since I banned high rise because of the landing and takeoff procedures of the airplanes. I did not want to crash the planes into the long buildings. So I already showed the main connection of the highway, and this roundabout is the main area which you connect to the zone and airport. So that's all about this zone. We will move to our seaport after this area. By the way, let me show you lastly the zones. I just created a small villa style housing here. I just imagined that some pilots, or what you can think, some pilots just stay here near the airport. They have an home here, or some airlines company can rent those homes and for their pilots or flight crew to stay at night instead of just those big hotels and crowded city. Here's a nice silent neighborhood for them to stay and rest before they take their flight out of the city. All right, and we will move to the seaport after here. Welcome to our harbor area. Harbor area is the main location for our ship traffic. Both passenger and cargo ships dock, come here and dock to their preferred terminals. So we have a nice cargo ship and a passenger ship docking to their terminals. We have three passenger and a lot of cargo terminals present in the area, but honestly, ships only use two of them. This one is rarely used, very very rarely used, and honestly, cargo ships are using those two. One at first when I built this area, they were using these three also, but after some time left and I increased the size, they stopped using these zones. So only this entrance area, let me show you like that. This is a small entrance area used by the ships mainly because of my customized ship routes, maybe, I don't know. They use mainly this area, and honestly, I can say that that is what I want. I just want to cross the ship traffic in here. It's just like a small zone for the ships. They go out, they get out, they get in, and create a crowded ship traffic. So here is our main railroad entrance, and this is the three-story railroad access which I told in the previous episode. We have only one railroad access which arrives to harbor area and divided into three. One is leads the train, one route leads the trains to right side, and other two is the left side. Let me show you like that. Those two upper flats take the left band, and other one, the bottom side, is just moves and take the right band, right turn, and arrive at cargo station. And as I already told it, they are not using this one, and I cannot see any train movement after a time before. So those two lines are used frequently, especially this one, mostly used, this one, and this one is a lesser one, used lesser by the trains. So the main point is this decoration area, middle of here, just gave the crowded harbor feeling to me when I just decorated it. It is just kind of crowded area with a lot of cranes and track movement, train movement, and a nice location. I also use some personalized night lighting here. Instead of assets default lighting, I added some light to give better feeling at night. So lastly, we have a cargo warehouse here, which trucks can come and grab their goods, then deliver the required goods any location in the city. We also have some two service buildings, police and fire department, and we have some recycle buildings here. Those buildings are belongs to office zones, and this area in general, this area all have office buildings. We don't have any industrial, residential or commercial buildings, just like the airport zone. I just imagined that those office buildings and workers in these buildings just deal with the import export operations and paperwork for the airport and seaport area. Then the goods come out of these zones, maybe low tax zones according to your imagination, and move to the city. Let me show a general view of my harbor area. So we have two landmarks here, just placed without anything in my mind. This Eiffel Tower, I just placed it to give feeling when planes take off or ships come from the sea, just like that. Those passengers in that plane just took off. Can see this tower, and you can just see it from the sea like that. When you move a ship, just coming closer to the passenger harbor, you can see the nice tower view. Right side, you can see nice airport view, and if you are lucky, you can see a plane landing. On the left side, you can see our ore industrial area, and with a lot of wind power generators on the mountain just behind that ore area. So I will move to my finance center from here, from this location, and see you in there. Hello from the finance center of the city. So you can see the finance center is just a location which includes only commercial buildings, no industrial, office or residential zones. We have also some landmarks here, like these few buildings, one here and one here. This financial zone consists of some skyscrapers and just small buildings just around these two big avenues. By the way, you can ask yourself that why I had got no traffic except those service vehicles and cargo trucks or lorries. Let me show you like that. Only generally cargo trucks and service vehicles, and very very few vehicle traffic, because as I already showed you in the latest episode, last episode, which I explained my public transportation operations in my city, we have a nice, very very nice subway network here, and those subway network connected with other public transportation options, and this honestly leads us to no traffic in around the area, and you can drive everywhere in a very very fast, in a very very efficiently. So the main traffic is on this bridge which leads into this residential zone, which I will show you on the next episode. So this area, as I already told it, it is my city's main financial center. So kind of just center of the city. Around of this financial center is just covered by a lot of residential zones, so people can just come to the center and arrive their work. Only problem is that seaport and airport is a little far location. Other than that, you can just take this North Highway and arrive this oil area and ore industry area. So this vacation island area. Also, you can just go my power plant area, farming industry and forest industry area in a very very fast way, since this area have district have just close highway connection. The only problem is this area don't have any direct connection from to the seaport and airport like that. Let me show you. For example, I just could create some connection from here, especially this area to that intersection, but since I just stopped playing with this city, and this city is only created for testing purposes, just did not think about building it, so I just leave it be. And now we have this location. So the city's main business and commercial area have skyscrapers in the middle. Just imagine like those big companies have big buildings in the center, and outskirts we have a lot of different and small companies operating and serving to the city. It is also close to my university, close to my tourist location, tourist district and leisure district, so that's why I can call this area is just the center of the city. Also this area is very very close to my favorite decorated mountain district. I already showed it this area in the previous episodes. So that's all for this episode. Just before I end this one, I wanted to show the night view of the locations which we saw in this episode. Let's start with this financial center area. Let me adjust my time to 10 p.m. Okay, 10, half past 10. Okay, nice. So it appears just a crowded big city. Let me show you like that. Just a big avenue and skyscrapers around it. A big crowded city and scenery. So just move to my airport and seaport area from here. This is my airport area. Those hotels and office buildings. My lighthouse. My cargo hub. Aircraft, cargo aircraft, parking aprons and cargo buildings which belongs to DHL and KLM. So this is the approach light I talked in just the start of the episode, and nice view from a plane just landed. This is our precision approach lights. Normally, as you already know, this airport is not as bright as in the default game, so I just placed I just placed some personalized customized assets, so it is bright. This is the general view of my international airport. Let me show a bit far from the point. Okay, now nice light. Now the last stop is my seaport area. In my opinion, that yellow lighting is appears very good on those crate zones, crate assets. It's very beautiful atmosphere to the district and an eye candy view of scenery, in my opinion. So my favorite location with the airport as commercial and industrial zones, between the commercial and industrial zones, my favorite two locations, the seaport and that airport. I already love to build them, and on the next series I will try to build better than this one. So now this is end of my episode, and as I always told you at the end of my episodes, please leave comments if you want to add anything, or if you want to criticize anything, just leave a comment, and that makes me happy to read your comments, by the way. And if you like my videos, just subscribe to my channel so you can see when I just release a new video. Hope to see you on the next and last episode of the season before I just move to season 2 on a different city building on a real life terrain 8 created map. So see you on the last episode and on the season 2. Bye bye.